Rekordbox analyzes a file and determines what is the first beat of a bar and what is the BPM, but sometimes that's wrong. You need to adjust that by adjusting the beat grid. How that works? Coming up. Welcome back. How are you doing? I hope you're doing marvelously well. For more videos about DJing and producing, subscribe and hit the bell. We can make adjustments in the beat grid of a song when Rekordbox analyzed the song wrong. We can do that in the beat grid. Over here in Rekordbox, you have the cue and the loop function. We already discussed that in the previous video, but there is a grid also. And in that grid, that grid means beat grid. And in that function, we can see how Rekordbox analyzed the file. In this case, I adjusted the file, but it's not correct. Let's try a analyze of the track. Over here, we can see there is a menu button. And when you press that, it will show a menu and it says analyze track normal and analyze track dynamic. There are two ways of analyzing, as you probably might have guessed. The normal way, and the normal way means a constant BPM of a song, and that is for electronic music probably not a problem because the BPM stays constant the entire song. Not always, but if that is not the case, you can use analyze track dynamic. And for a lot of analog songs, for example, the songs that are played by an orchestra or a band, for example, you need to use the function analyze track dynamic. The standard way is analyze normal, and I'll show you that for now because I know that the beat grid of the beat, the BPM of this track is constant. Normal, and what do I want to analyze? BPM grid in a certain BPM range, so it isn't entirely off. Key, that is the key of a song. I don't want to do that because I use the Camelot keys, and Rekordbox recognizes the key of a song and says A minor, B major, for example. But I've done that with mixed in key and I don't want to override that, so I'll don't check this one or the phrase detection. Both I'll leave off. I'll say okay. And now it will analyze the track indeed. And you will see that the track is analyzed, but it's way off. And the first hint when you see a song and Rekordbox says on the beginning of the song, it says the first count of a bar, the first beat of a bar is over here. And that is with electronic music mostly not the case. I think it's over here, but we'll see that later. Easier to see that is over here because it is really obvious. This is by looking at the waveform, you can see it's blue. So that means not a lot of bass, but the bass starts here, and that bass is, you see, red, red, red. That is the kick. So what I'll do is I will set it over here. Let's first explain the cue function. When I'm over here, I want to jump to the first beat of the first near beat, and I can do that with the cue function. This cue, that is the quantize function. When I have this off, then it won't jump to the next beat. It will mark this point, and that is in case this case this yellow mark over here. When I say cue now, it will jump with this on, it will jump to that beat. And if the next beat is nearer to this one, it will jump to that beat. But when I do it with the cue, when I cue it with that cue, so the quantize function off, you will see that it will make a mark and that yellow triangle will jump on that first beat, because I think it's the first beat of a bar. Let's check it, to be sure, let's check it. I'll rewind the song a bit. Okay, that's totally the first beat of the bar, indeed. You can hear by hearing the beeping sound was the metronome. I can switch it on and off. And when I press it on and it says blue, then you will hear that metronome. That is the beeping of those detected bars, the detected beats of a bar. You can set the volume if you think it's too loud. And I want a louder. Okay. That was metronome. But now I'll jump to the first beat of a bar. And I'll say Q. And now I want to point to that as the first beat of a bar. I can go to the first beat of a bar button over here and I'll press it. And you'll see that all the beats will jump to another place. Again, the red thing is the first beat of a bar. Now let's check it with the metronome on. I think it's pretty close, but we'll... It's pretty close. It is not close enough for me. Even if it was just for sake of the video. Let's zoom in. Now we can make it a more precise cut. I think it's probably here because the top kick is here, but okay. But that is not the way I want to do it this time. I want to shift the whole beat grid to the left. And that means when I zoom out that all these thingies that are over here that are marking a beat will jump to the left. I can show you that, and I have to press it a lot of times because it is a really small shift, but if I press it a lot of times you will see that all that that marks will jump to the left. But of course I can make it more to the right. Now let's hear if that is the correct counting. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. But sometimes when a track is dynamic in tempo, for example, and you can't solve that correctly by using the analyse function, you have to adjust that manually. But sometimes you don't want to apply those changes for the whole track. You want only the last part of your song be influenced by your changes. You can do that with this function over here. Apply the changes to the current position and everything that comes after that position. I'll press this button and then you'll see that the markings will disappear over here, and that if I change anything that it will only apply to what comes after this. You'll think, well, I can set if the tempo changes throughout the song, then the first beat of a bar changes sometimes too, or it is a really badly produced track, and then I have sometimes a count short, or a beat short, or a beat over. If you want to adjust that for the first count of a beat, set that correctly further in the song, that doesn't work. Rekordbox doesn't work that way. So really annoying, but regretfully it is that way. So when I say, if I make a change now and I say make adjustments to current position and after, then I say first beat of a bar, it will change for the whole song. But when I do changes, for example, shift the whole beat grid to the right, then it will work. And just pay attention, this option is selected now, and I'll want to shift the whole beat grid after that position to the right, and you'll see that only the right side will be influenced, and I can do it back. Okay, and if I now want to apply those whole changes to the whole track, then you'll see that now my changes are applied to the whole track. Sometimes you need to expand the grid and the beat intervals, and you have to compress it. Therefore, you can use this button. Expand the beat intervals and shrink the beat intervals. Expand it. And you will see that the BPM over here will change also. And now let's shrink it. Sometimes a song is 80 BPM and Rekordbox recognizes it as a song of 160 beats per minute. That is wrong, but yeah, wrong. But it is easier to have the correct beats, the correct BPM. What we can do now is I'll press the times 2 button. And then if you look over here, then you'll see that this will double. So I'll say double. And you'll see it will double. And when I say half, it will half the BPM. When I made the changes in a track and I have spent a lot of time to make the beat grid the correct way, you don't want to lose that change by, for example, by accident pressing the analyze function. What we can do is lock the beat grid. And I have to press on the lock over here, and you will see that the lock will close. Then the changes you do, you can't change it now anymore. You can't click here. And if you analyze a song, you'll see it is grayed out. But if I do an analyze of different tracks, more than one track, then this track isn't analyzed. So that safeguards that the things you've done are not lost. For more videos about DJing, producing, and videos like this Rekordbox tutorial for beginners, subscribe to the channel and hit that bell button to get notifications when I upload a new video. This video is part of the series Rekordbox tutorial for beginners. A link to the YouTube series you can find in the description below. Was this valuable information? I'd like to know by giving me a thumbs up. Also, if you have a question about Rekordbox or adjusting the beat grid, leave it down in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye! Hey.